So Luke, a 1-1 draw with Altrincham, what are your reactions from the game?
I think first half they should be out of sight. They dominated the game of football. Too much respect, played 15 yards off the play. They had their patterns, didn't stick to what we wanted from the boys. And I felt second half for 25 minutes, I thought we were very productive. We went and got the goal in that period, and I think we took our foot off the gas. And you look at the opposition you're playing, he sets their team up superbly. He's got a great manner, a manner in where they stretch up, play real open, expansive football. I think he's a superb manager. And I think they deserve the draw minimum. I'm not foolish. I watched the game for what it is. I'm over the moon at 1-1 because I think that I'll take a point, wipe our mouth and move on. They beat the likes of Notts County here. They got 2 points per game at home. Their stats are frightening for a team that are currently, I think, sitting 8th or 9th. To come away from home, to come 4 hours up the road against the team in Manchester and nick a point, I think I'm very happy.
A slight reshuffle at the back today with Dave Stevens coming in and Jamal playing left centre-back. What did you make of Jamal's performance today?
Gets his goal. And then I think for me that there's an issue that we don't stop the quick free kick, then we don't defend the least amount of pitch, and Jamal will know exactly what I mean by that comment. He lets him roll inside. He's got 3-4 options sliding up the side of our centre-half unit, whereas if he locks it and keeps them loaded down the outside, there's an opportunity to go create a 2v2 in him and Mendy's favour. We don't do that. We get a good block from Rico, and then Hancock goes and finishes with great quality. They bring Whitehead on. They bring Piers on. They still got the boys Pringle not playing, Furman not playing. They are a good, good, good team. Really, really good team. I've been in it now seven seasons, 6 years, and I know full well when you've taken a good point. Today's that. I said to the group at halftime, that's not a polished away day. That's a poor performance. That's us being way off our mark, not doing what we've been doing recent weeks to go and get the rewards. And then I felt, like I said, second half, we were very productive. Got in their faces, didn't allow them to get their rhythm. And yeah, we got the rewards. We could have gone 2-0 up with Gus, who just hits the side of the post. But look, I think it'd be really unfair for Phil and his team if we had taken 3 points.
And Denon Lewis, new signing, came on today. It was tough for him as he only came on with about 10 minutes. What have you made of his performance today and his performance during the week?
He's been really good. Obviously, it's tough because you look at Bodes and Marshy, they have little spells and you think, go on then, I'll keep him on because of that. And then, to be fair, it's being nice in a position to go 2-for-2. You look at Clifton comes on, I think he has another impact. And I think Denon, if you can get him down the sides of him and racing, I think Gus had one opportunity where he could have probably left it along the floor to engage the centre-half out a little bit wider. He's gone and got the centre-half back in the game with putting it in the air. But look, he'll be a massive plus for us. I think Frankie had a reaction. I think Cliff had a reaction. I think Denon had a reaction. It's nice that the fact that we come up north without Ashmore, without Femile Samney, and we still have that bench to our disposal. So yeah, I'm happy with their inclusions. I'm happy with how Denon's been this week. He'll only get better as we start to improve in terms of our organisation side of things with him. But again, we shuffled the pack, like you said, at the back. Unfortunately, we couldn't get a clean sheet. We tried our hardest, but I thought Dave Stevens had a good game. And for me, it just shows you where we're at with a squad. Do we need a couple? Yeah, that's obvious for everyone at the club to see, but we're grafting, we're trying to get them in the building, and they've got to be the right ones because I think this group have worked so hard. I don't want to get it wrong at this stage.
And one thing that I noticed today, discipline. There was a couple of yellow cards and offsides. There was quite a few offsides today. Is that something you're going to address with the boys after the game?
Yeah, offsides are offsides. People are tired. People are leggy. We've got Marshy have probably played however many, probably up to 1,000 minutes now, or just over 1,200 minutes. I think that's a lot of minutes in a short space of time. Like Bowden, we train at an intensity. So they are a little bit tired, a little bit leggy getting back on side. What I hate about that is it allows the team to reset and get an attack on you. The yellow card, Kane Smith got a yellow card for a tackle. I can't think that's so too much of an ill discipline. I think at the later stages, I was telling the group to disrupt them because if they're going on the counter, I'd rather deal with a long ball into our box as opposed to their threats in Colclough, Cossillo, Whitehead that come on the pitch, Hancock, Piers that come on late stages. They like to slide up the side of you, they like to run at you, and you see that with a lot of their opportunities today. So for me, yeah, I don't think it was much ill discipline. Yeah, offsides, yeah, it happens in a game. How many did they have? But I'm just ecstatic that we've gone and taken a point because I do genuinely believe they're going to be a team that's going to cause upsets. You see it in their Notts County win here. You see it in 2 points per game. Yeah, they're a great outfit and they've got a good manager.